Hello Zikos, today I will show you a new technique pretty nice to do on the tin whistle. This is called the tap. Okay, this is the extreme opposite of the cat we've seen before in a video. We use the tap to push your note. If you play a note, you want to continue this note by executing a tap. So let's go for one example. We can take the same example as the cat. Okay, I play two identical notes with a tongue-tonguing separation. Okay, I play two behind each note. Now I will play the same example, but we can add one tap on the second note. Okay. And the first note, we play tongue-tonguing behind, okay? So for example, we can get this kind of result. You can notice that the sound is quite different than a cat, okay, and the movement too. Now, how to do the tap properly? You can play one note, for example, we play E, and we will tap the note just below, okay, so that's the reason why we can't do a tap on a D, okay. We haven't got a hole just behind, okay? So, to make it properly, you have to play your note, the E, and tap the hole just behind with energy, okay? Okay, very slowly, we have a D, okay? When you have this kind of result, okay, you are on the D, you have to raise your finger very quickly, like that. Okay? Very slowly, you can have this. You haven't got to wait so long on the tap, okay? Don't do that. Even if you play slowly, okay? If you play slowly, with lots of energy. Let's get practice on the full scale. You can do this kind of exercise very slowly, but with lots of energy. Okay, now you can practice this exercise very often, okay, if you want every day, 1 hour, this is a joke, if you want 5 minutes a day or 10 minutes a day, okay, every day if you want, okay. So, when it's okay for you, you understand the movement, you can speed up the movement, you can go faster, like that. This is really important to speed your movement because we can't play a tune like that. This is too loud. Okay, you have a you haven't got to wait so much on the tap. Okay, so do it very properly and with lots of energy. Okay, be careful. The only thing we can do with the tap is only to separate two identical notes. You can't do another thing. This is just for separating two identical notes. Be careful again. We can't do a tap with a tonguing behind. Okay. If you do a two-tonguing, for example, behind your tap, this is not correct because you must cut your sound. Okay. For example, if you do that, you can have this kind of result. You can hear that my sound is cut by the tonguing. Okay, I would like to inspire you to finish this video doing tap and practice lots of your tap. I will show you one tune which have lots of tap in it. Okay, to finish this video and to inspire you doing more taps in your play. For example, I haven't got the name of this tune. If you have it, please comment just below this video and let's go for the tune. For watching this video, if you enjoy it, feel free to share it and comment just below the video. And if you want, you can like the video and subscribe to this channel if you want to have more videos like this in English. Okay, I made lots of tutorials in French, but I do this in English for my student who doesn't understand French. So if you want more English video, please subscribe to this channel and see you for the next video. Ciao.